Leeds football derby, Rick Astley goes...
Needle matches of the season. In red, the Arsenal entertainers. Look out for top scorer Angus Deaton. Ex-Bandar Valley striker Tony Hadley wearing 3 and 5, EastEnder Phil Mitchell. They're up against a team that's been getting quite a lot of attention over the last few weeks. The wet team in lilac. How very fetching. They've got some pretty useful players as well. Keyboardist Neil Mitchell, guitarist Graeme Clark, and a very interesting newcomer, Toby Anstis. And a few moments ago, Toby himself spoke to the Wets.
Here we are then, chaps at Highbury. Are we confident about the match that's coming up?
Absolutely.
Where are you both playing then? Have we got any positions sorted out yet?
Okay, well, we need...
Right back in the dressing room.
You need to talk to the manager about that. If I'm selected, then I'll just be able to play.
And who is the manager? Because Marty here doesn't appear to be in a football kit. We were told you were playing. What's happened?
No, I'm an injury and I'm benched. So to speak. Tommy is in fact
what I might do, I'm like a co-manager, I might bring Marty on halfway through the match actually just to finish off. If there's short and goals, we'll bring on our star player.
Right.
Obviously push it forward, no? Because what happened is Neil passes the ball out, get it to Graeme, Graeme crosses it, gives it to Marty, Marty heads it, Marty shoots, Marty scores. It's the way it works in this business.
Just went to this league.
Thank you very much there, Tommy. I thought you were going to say, and Marty misses.
And Marty misses.
I must say, I do like the kits as well. These are beautiful.
In case anyone doesn't know, these are actually available. The real thing. This is from the football. We are sponsoring Clydebank Football Club. A local
That's
team.
Right, yeah, I heard about that.
If you drive through on a Saturday, you get all these like 45-year-old men, you know, big hairy men with beer cans in their hand and wet across it. So our new fans are actually 45-year-old men. It's
You're
swigging.
I'm
Los Angeles!
But they're having a brilliant season, though. It's brilliant timing to sponsor them, isn't it? Because are they on top of the Division 1 as we speak?
Yeah, we are over the moon. Long may it last. Keep it up. Okay, good work, lads.
Now, Marty, I was going to ask you about...
Tommy.
Not about Tommy.
No, not about Tommy.
But instead about... an advert that I gather you've recently just declined to do.
And that was a shampoo advert that I was offered and it was brought to my attention that the testosterone
levels... So you were going to ask, on one side of your head an ordinary shampoo and the other side in
a... Yes, and it was brought to my attention that the testosterone levels, and I believe that the band strongly believe that it would be for the evolution of that.
Yeah, good stuff. So you won't be appearing in that, but maybe in Tommy?
Well, maybe on Tommy, that's just something that I'm considering.
Mm-hmm. Would that not mean taking a lot of time away from the band? Well, I think, are we all ready to go then? I think they're waiting in the stadium. Here we go. I'm going to finish lacing these.
High spirits there in the wet camp as the game kicks off here at Highbury. It's a game of two halves and only one team can win. Here comes Hadley. Good skill from Hadley. And he passes it over to his teammate, Robbie G, who takes it. Oh, and disaster for the Wets as Arsenal take an early lead. Our man Toby Anstis checks his pulse as the action hots up. Back thundering down the pitch. It's good combination there from Clark and Mitchell. And Deaton is fouled. The Wets can see the penalty. Oh, it's Arsenal goal. Wet recover. So much at stake here this evening. The ball waiting to be kicked.
Yes.
Anstis pushes forward and shoots. Oh, and he hits the post. He was unlucky there. Had it gone in, it would have been a goal. Excellent play there from Clark. This looks promising. And a cracking goal there for the Wets. 2-1. An absolute gem. It's a real goal fest this evening for Wet. And yet another glorious goal! Oh yes, a masterpiece! Fantastic play! And as the ref blows his whistle, it's Arsenal 2, Wet 3.
Hey Marty. Good result, eh?
Oh, amazing, eh? Wasn't it?
And you were not bad yourself. You're the close one, but...
I was going dizzy out there. It's a different game, isn't it?
We've done very well. We've done admirably. Of course, you know. Tom's really good at the final word on whether you'll get a match again, you know.
Come on then, get your kit on. You should be out there now. See you absorbing the atmosphere.
Still injured, no. Tam never picked me, so.
While they were playing football,
You know earlier you said that you'd do anything for me?
Yeah.
Could you just sniff this bit for me?
Yeah, hold on.
You see, they haven't even been washed. Any wet fan would die for one of these t-shirts. And look, this is another interesting fact about these t-shirts. That's one way of spelling Tommy, okay?
Yeah.
And then, And then there's another one. It's nice to know that wet can all spell their own names. I'm sure you can really, Lash. You're probably very tired. The question, don't rush me, the question is, where is the rainiest place in Britain? That's where is the rainiest place in Britain? Write your answer down on the back of a postcard or stuck down envelope and send it to this address. Children's BBC, PO Box 4567, London W12 6AA. That's Children's BBC, PO Box 4567, London W12 6AA. Good luck.
Hey, Flipper, there was these two fleas coming out of a cinema, yeah? And it starts to rain, and one said, shall we walk? And the other one goes, no, let's take the dog.
Oh, that's a good one, that. Hey, there was this insect-catching net in the studio, right?
Yeah.
And we suddenly realised it's just about the right size for catching a cat in it.
What?
Yeah, that's a good one, that, isn't it?
Don't forget, next week we've got Time Busters, the Lizard Train, Maggot Moments, the Last of Rugrats, Brain Chill, and all that.
Goodbye.
I'm off catching me indeed.